So we got one of our sisters here that's talking about something that's been a hot topic for a long time in the Black community. Let's review it.
So boom, check this out. I got a PSA. We don't want government assistance. We want our Black men home. That's all.
Well, I mean, you actually said a mouthful on that one. I will give you that. But let's talk about that. You know, you had Black men in the home. If you go prior to the time of all the welfare, Black men were in the home. You had two parent households. Of course, this was before the time of the no fault divorce, where you can just show up and say, I want a divorce. Why you want one? Why? Because I just don't want to be in this marriage anymore. You know, before that time period, you actually had the Black men in the home. But then after the civil rights movement and it came in with all the welfare, right, the women set up here and chose to get the welfare over saying, you know what, I know we're struggling. I'm just going to struggle with my man and deal with it. Because at that time period, they say, well, a man can't be in the house. So you have a lot of men that at the time period could not be in the house getting this welfare. Now, how is it that other groups kept they men in the household and getting the same welfare? White women was getting welfare. How did they figure out to keep their man in the household? Hispanic women was getting welfare at that time period. We got talking about back in the, you know, late 60s, early 70s, all this time period. How is it all these different people kept the people in their household? But our community had this big, you know, exodus of men out of there due to the choice, because there was a choice. The government didn't force anyone to take welfare. They didn't force it. It was a choice. We had done very well in this country coming out of slavery all the way up until that time without welfare. We figured out a way as a people to make it, to raise our children, to keep a roof over our head, to keep clothes on the back of our children. So we've been figuring it out for hundreds of years that way. Why in the hell it took that one thing to cause a rift like that? Then you after that welfare and get the men out of the household. Now here you come in with the feminism coming from Becky. She telling you talking about feminism, but she's still in the house with her man. You understand? But she gassing your head up against your man. It was all finesse. Then between those two things, then you got to drop in the crack epidemic in the 80s. That happened going into the 90s, destroyed a lot of families. These three strike, you know, laws took a lot of men out of the household that way too. Took some women out of the household, but it that caused a big single parenting epidemic to start in our community, which had been detrimental. When the single parenting epidemic happened, then you had this matriarchy that came in. Prior to that, you had more of a patriarchy in the Black community. So now you fast forward all the way to 2022 and times are hard and getting harder. With jobs going away, inflation is high, groceries is high, all kind of bills is high. Women are realizing, wait a minute, I don't have a luxury no more like I used to. I felt I didn't need a man. I actually need a man. Because from what economists are saying, in the next 18 to 24 months, it's really about to get harder. And who's going to suffer? Women. More than men will. And this is the time, women, to get you a man. I'm talking about a decent man. I'm not talking about a sorry Pookie and Ray Ray. If you need to put, if you get a sorry Pookie and Ray Ray, you might as well stay by yourself. Because that's a waste of time. But you need a man. You better stop listening to them women telling you, you don't need no man. All you need is you make a certain amount of money. You know, you can go to get you a toy and all of that and get the rolls and all the stuff that y'all be talking about online. Okay, fine. But with that rolls or you know, whatever job you have, will it fix the car? Will it fix the refrigerator? Will it protect you when somebody's trying to break into your house 2-3 in the morning? Will it do any of that? Will it look out for you like a man will? And a man can work more and do more than you. Because we just built to, even in the area of provision. You know, when you weaken and all that, and you need your man to hold you up. See, when you by yourself, you don't have all that. And that's why this woman is saying, we need our men back. Yeah. Now, I'm not blaming her generation for getting that started, because it was not her generation. Actually, it would be my parents' generation. The women of that time got that started. It wasn't even my generation. It was them. Just breaking that down. I thought about it like when the breakdown actually happened. And it happened in my parents' generation. It happened then because like my parents were born in like the mid to late 50s. And then they grew up, you know, during the time they was like, what, 10, 11, 12, around the civil rights movement. They came into their teenage years and adult years in the 70s when all this newfound freedom and all this mess came in. So it was around that time period and those, you know, that generation. It wasn't a Gen X. It wasn't millennials. It definitely wasn't Gen Z. But now you're dealing with the aftermath and the fallout of all of that. And now some of you are realizing, wait a minute, well, we need the men back. We need them. This is not cool being by myself. It's not cool raising kids by myself. I look up and see all these other group of women got their men, but where's mine? And that's the right way to think because that's the natural order of things. We have been walking around with a perverted family relationship and mentality. The natural order is a man and a woman together taking on the world, raising their kids, building something. That's the natural order of things. Sure, you can do things in a perverted manner by yourself, all these alternative things, you know, that people want to do right in their life. And you could halfway function, but you're never happy. I always see happy women that's in a great relationship, great marriage, and more at peace when they are married and have their man versus women who are by themselves. Now, I'm not saying a woman can't function by herself. I'm not going to say a woman can't be by herself the rest of her life. It's not for everybody to be married. I'm not saying everybody needs to be married. Some women never have children. They don't want children. They don't want marriage. And that's fine. If they want to be that way, that's no problem. Some men will never get married either. But that's the minority. That's not the majority. That I will say. So, yes, ladies, get your man back. Stop listening to them females out here. Or you will be out here choosing a stud. But y'all let me know what y'all think about this sister talking about. Because like I said, she's spot on. Definitely need those men in the household.